Thank you all for joining us today. My name is Sam Husseini. I'm with Exposed Facts. It's a project of the Institute for Public Accuracy that seeks to protect whistleblowers as well as to expose critical government and corporate wrongdoing and criminality. We're delighted today to be joined by two very knowledgeable speakers about some critical issues pertaining to whistleblowers, a free press, and the threats to them. In recent days, we have seen the head of the CIA call WikiLeaks a threat and a let me get the exact words correctly, hostile intelligence service. And we've also seen the Attorney General of the United States, Jeff Sessions, as we are here before the place that calls itself the Department of Justice, Jeff Sessions saying that it is a priority to go after Julian Assange, the publisher of WikiLeaks. We won't be able to be joined today with Jess Raddick, who's head of the Whisper, the whistleblower and source protection program at Exposed Facts. She's fallen ill. But we are delighted to have, cue up our first speaker. Ann Wright is a 29-year veteran of the Army and the Army Reserves. And she's also had a long distinguished career in the State Department, serving in many locales, including Nicaragua, Sierra Leone, Uzbekistan, and elsewhere. She actually helped open up the U.S. Embassy in Afghanistan in 2001. In 2003, in March of 2003, as the U.S. was invading Iraq, she resigned her post in protest. And since then, she's been a remarkable activist on a number of issues, especially on protection of whistleblowers. Anne.
Thank you. My name is Anne Wright. I'm a retired U.S. Army colonel. I spent 29 years in the U.S. military. I also was a U.S. diplomat for 16 years and served in U.S. embassies in Nicaragua, Grenada, Somalia, Uzbekistan, Kyrgyzstan, Sierra Leone, Micronesia. I helped reopen the U.S. Embassy in Kabul, Afghanistan in December of 2001. I also was in Mongolia, and it was in Mongolia in 2003 that I ended up resigning from the U.S. government in opposition to the war in Iraq. With that background, I want to say I stand firmly beside Julian Assange, a person who has been a leader in making sure, a journalist who has been making sure that we understand the brave role that whistleblowers have had in our government. Whistleblowers, for example, Chelsea Manning, that released over a quarter of a million documents from the U.S. government in what was called collateral damage. Collateral damage where Chelsea Manning was horrified by what she saw of the U.S. military killing Reuters reporters, journalists. And it was WikiLeaks, Julian Assange, and those who formed WikiLeaks that were so instrumental in moving the message that we have from whistleblowers to include Ed Snowden. Ed Snowden, who is now in Russia for having disclosed a tremendous amount of information about the eavesdropping and spying our government, the U.S. government, was doing on people around the world, and to include us as U.S. citizens. Violating the laws, both under the Bush administration and the Obama administration, with the wholesale collection of electronic data on every person on this earth. And if it had not been for Ed Snowden making that tremendous revelation, and a journalist team similar to the New York Times, the Washington Post, but this is called WikiLeaks, it is a journalistic endeavor to let us know what these whistleblowers are saying. It is in the same vein that we had 40 years ago when the whistleblower Dan Ellsberg released the Pentagon Papers, and the journalists of America, particularly the New York Times and the Washington Post, against the wishes of the Nixon administration, released the massive volume, 5,000 pages of data on the history of why the U.S. was involved in Vietnam, caused the war, and the humongous numbers of human rights violations and violations of our own law conducting that war on Vietnam, a war that killed over 4 million Vietnamese. So Dan Ellsberg, who wishes he could be here today as the most dangerous man in America, as President Richard Nixon called Dan Ellsberg, dangerous for releasing data that shows the criminal actions of our state, the criminal actions of the United States of America, and Chelsea Manning, Ed Snowden, Thomas Drake, John Kiriakou, all of these whistleblowers are in the same vein as Dan Ellsberg. And Dan sends a message from California to us at the press conference, where we are challenging the Department of Justice and Attorney General Jeff Sessions in his latest comment, saying that it is a priority of the U.S. government, of the Department of Justice, to arrest and prosecute Julian Assange for espionage against the United States. And yet, it is not espionage. It is indeed the right of journalists to disclose this information that we as American citizens and people of the world need to know. So Dan Ellsberg, as the grandfather of all whistleblowers, so to speak, sends this message. Obama, having opened the legal campaign against the press by going after the roots of investigative reporting on national security, the sources, and Trump is going to go after the gatherers, the gardeners themselves, and their bosses, the publishers. To switch the metaphor, an indictment of Julian Assange is the first use of a nuclear option against the First Amendment protection of a free press. And by the way, the charges they are reporting, considering against Julian, conspiracy, theft, and violation of the Espionage Act, are exactly the same charges I faced in 1971. If journalists and publishers fail to call this out, renounce and resist it on the spurious grounds that Julian is not a real journalist like themselves, they are offering themselves up to Trump and Sessions for indictments and prosecutions, which will eventually silence all but the heroes and heroines among them. So we call on the Justice Department to drop any investigations and drop any attempts at arresting and prosecuting Julian Assange. He should be given an award by the people of the world for exposing the criminal acts committed by the United States of America's government. Thank you. I'd like to now ask Sam to introduce.
Okay. Thanks so much. We're releasing that statement by Dan Ellsberg. Thanks so much, Anne. I think that Dan's statement is remarkable in part because a lot of the people who have attacked WikiLeaks over the years have said, well, what they're doing and what Chelsea Manning did and so on, that's no good. That's not like what Dan Ellsberg did with the Pentagon Papers. And Ellsberg has come forward repeatedly and said, no, actually, it's a lot like what I did. As a matter of fact, in certain cases, Dan released stuff that was at a higher security clearance. But there have been a lot of people, and there needs to be more people speaking out who have had disagreements with WikiLeaks, but see this as a pernicious threat to the First Amendment in general. And part of the fear, I think, is that a lot of journalists who are not heroes are already silent, and that the tentacles of the Department of Justice, if they are able to prosecute individuals, they will also prosecute those who are heroes and be faced with criminal prosecution, which is a very effective form of silencing the media. Let me, before I introduce Ray, I want to highlight what I think he's going to talk about, and that is reasons for the government going after WikiLeaks. A lot of they put out a ton of information, and sometimes it's difficult to wade through it, but so much of it is relevant to a lot of what we see. Chelsea Manning will be released on May 17th, who of course released the collateral murder video, which showed criminality. They released things like the cables regarding U.S. conduct in 2006, saying, well, you know, we really should use the Shiite-Sunni schism in Syria to our advantage, leading to those kinds of policies, leading to civil war in Syria, utter disaster for hundreds of thousands, for millions of people, foreshadowed by internal U.S. government documents. And I think that that's a good deal of why WikiLeaks is so annoying to those in power. Ray McGovern was a briefer for numerous presidents, worked at the CIA, is a CIA veteran. Since leaving government, he founded Sam Adams Associates for Integrity, and they gave Julian Assange their award in 2010. The group opposes any attempts to silence or prosecute Julian Assange. Ray.
Good morning, and thank you for coming out. Can you hear me okay? You can. Okay. Well, welcome to the deep state. This is a charter member here. Of course, James Comey in the FBI building, he and his former colleague, John Brennan, and the head of the NSA, you know, these are folks that comprise the deep state, and that's why we're here. Now, the deep state really, really, really doesn't like Julian Assange, okay? Why? Well, it's very clear. Julian Assange has revealed U.S. war crimes. Shooting up civilians, shooting up kids in a little van during the surge in Iraq is a war crime, okay? That's one reason they hate him. And guess what? You know, the oft-heard explanation as to why Julian Assange shouldn't publish these documents is because of our troops over there. They might get injured or killed. Well, that dog won't hunt, okay? The Secretary of Defense, Robert Gates at the time, call those charges, quote, significantly overwrought. Now, what's the latest? Well, the latest is this charge that WikiLeaks hacked into the Democratic National Committee. Did they? No. They got a leak from the Democratic National Committee. And you know what? I have a good source for the fact that WikiLeaks didn't hack into the Democratic National Committee. His name is Barack Obama, okay? And this is what he said 2 days before he left office. I want to quote him precisely. I have it right here. At his January 11th press conference, Obama admitted, quote, the conclusions of the intelligence community with respect to the Russian hacking are not conclusive with respect to how WikiLeaks got the Russian hack. Now, I got news for you folks, I've figured it out. Was the DNC hacked? Sure it was. It was hacked by probably 50 people, 50 hackers. Now, what do we know from recent WikiLeaks revelations? And this is really embarrassing to the CIA. We have CIA documents showing that over a period, well, it's not in the document, but I know from the former technical director of NSA that CIA worked with NSA for 15 years, count them, 15 years, to develop an art form which was great at, quote, obfuscating the source of leaks. Now, I asked Bill Binney, the technical director from NSA, I said, well, you know, how much does that cost to develop a? He says, well, it involves 700 million lines of code. And I said, well, thanks, Bill. What does that mean? He says, one line of code costs $25. Do the math, Ray, do the math. Now, that's in Vault 7 disclosure as of March 31st this year. Do you see it in the New York Times? No. Washington Post? No. They get, you know, the New York Times, they get a kind of a guidance every morning, all the news that's not fit to print, okay? Don't endanger the deep state. So what am I saying here? I'm saying that the DNC was hacked. And when James Comey goes before the House Intelligence Committee and very embarrassingly says, well, you know, we never got access to the computers there in the DNC. I know, it's best to have direct access for the forensics, but we had to depend on this commercial CrowdStrike, and so we didn't get direct access, but we know CrowdStrike is great. Well, okay, CrowdStrike might be great. That's the one that the DNC hired to look into this. But CrowdStrike has not worked for 15 years with NSA and has not developed 700 million lines of code. So, were Comey, now get this, it's not too complicated. Were Comey to insist, as he should have, I want access to the computers in the DNC, what would have happened? His investigators would have gone there and they would have found out that CrowdStrike wasn't up to this. They would have had to enlist the help of NSA to blow its own operation. CIA discharges these things because they do the real secret stuff. NSA gives them the technical capability. So, in a word, I think I know who hacked the DNC and left telltale signs like a little Cyrillic, and maybe the name of the first head of the Soviet secret police. Well, yeah, that was done. And to their credit, CrowdStrike found them, but they were left there by John Brennan. And that's why they hate WikiLeaks. Now, are these comments by Julian Assange, are these kind of interpretations, or his take on these things, as is often heard in the media? No! He's got the kind of material he gives to us that former intelligence officers, and I hope current intelligence analysts, absolutely lust after. Documentary evidence that has been proven to be purer than Caesar's wife. That's why they hate him. It's terribly embarrassing. Not only embarrassing, there are crimes being committed here. And Comey, Admiral Rogers from the NSA, and John Brennan, and now his faithful follower, Mike Pompeo, are fully participants in this crime. I want to say one other thing, but it escapes me right now, so I think I'll close. Thank you very much.
I want to say one other thing. Please. Ray, come over here. I want to say that Ray McGovern and Jesslyn Radak and Colleen Rowley and Thomas Drake were the first two, or the first group of persons to actually talk to Ed Snowden when he went to Moscow. You were the first ones to go to Moscow and actually have an interview with him. All of this to say that we are so appreciative of what WikiLeaks has done and what Julian Assange and the whole WikiLeaks team has done to expose the crimes, and in fact, go find the criminal.
Why do those fire engines have CNN signs on them?
Corporate America. Well, we are here to say that to our Justice Department and to our whole law enforcement team, there are criminals out there, that's for sure. But it's not Julian Assange, and it's not Ed Snowden, it's not Chelsea Manning, it's not Thomas Drake. Those are the people that expose the criminal acts of the government. And we're here to tell the Justice Department to clean up your own act and to prosecute those that actually have committed crimes and leave Julian Assange alone.
Amen. And I have another thing here. I remember what I wanted to say. You know, having worked for 27 years at the CIA and having watched things since then, I came to the conclusion that the CIA, FBI, and the NSA, the deep state is running this place, this whole place, okay? But I never had evidence before. Now I have evidence, okay? Does it come from a pretty good source? Well, if you consider the minority head of the Senate, Chuck Schumer, Senate Minority Leader, if you consider him a good source, well, I leave that up to you. He told Rachel Maddow on air,
you know, I used to think that President Trump was a pretty smart guy, but he's done something very foolish. Rachel said, well, what's that? He's taken on the CIA. And the CIA has six ways to Sunday to get you. So I thought he was a pretty smart businessman, but you know, this is very foolish what he's done. Now, Rachel Maddow, of course, rose to the occasion and she said, we're gonna go to break. Well, what would the question have been, folks? The question should have been, are you saying that the President of the United States should be afraid of the CIA? That's of course what he's saying. He knows, he's been around here. That's why there is a deep state, and they've admitted it now. Even Democrats admit it. Thanks.
In just a moment, we would like for you to acknowledge the presence of many supporters that are here for Julian Assange and all the whistleblowers. And just a moment, we'll start moving down to the Attorney General Jeff Sessions' office to let him know with a big loudspeaker and lots of signs. So how about all the supporters, great Code Pink Women for Peace and all other supporters, come back and let's get some signs and hold them up now.
Thank you so much for joining us today. There's a lot of talk about government shutdown, and I think that we've heard a good case that there's at least one part of the government that does desperately need to be shut down. Thank you very much.
Protect the truth, protect whistleblowers.
I'm sorry, before we do that, any Q&A? Okay. I feel like we need to have some level of accountability at all functions.
From Internews, I have a question for Governor Gray. They claim day in and day out on the news media that there are multiple investigations going on in the Senate, in the House, and in the CIA, as well as the FBI. Do you think we're going to ever come to the truth of what took place during the 2016 election? Or the hacking issue?
Well, you know, it's kind of difficult. The hacking issue is a canard, okay? It's an issue raised by sore losers, people who can't conceive of the possibility that Hillary Clinton lost the election because she was a fatally flawed candidate that nobody trusted. Couldn't be that, no? And so they started, even 2 days before the Democratic National Committee, to blame it on the Russians. The hacking would be blamed on the Russians. And ever since then, the mainstream media has fallen in line, and they've diverted attention to what those emails say. And what they say, folks, is simply that Hillary Clinton and her colleagues at the Democratic National Committee stole the nomination from Bernie Sanders. That, I think, is why you had a leak. I think there was a young Democratic National Committee worker who said, you know, man, this is beyond the pale. I was a Bernie supporter. I decided to work for Hillary, but man, what corruption. She cheated him out of the nomination. I'm going to send this little thumb drive to Julian Assange. That's what happened. Otherwise, NSA would know, because NSA collects everything from origin to destination. And you don't have to believe me about that. Believe the fellow who invented this system. His name is Bill Binney, and he used to work at NSA as the technical director. So it's convoluted, and I'm persuaded that since we know many people hacked into the DNC, this very vulnerable computer system, and CrowdStrike is the only outfit that's been allowed to look at them. Well, nothing is going to be really clarified unless we replace Comey with somebody who's honest and says, all right, go look at those computers now. And then if you need to, go to NSA and say, how did you actually furnish John Brennan with the wherewithal to make it appear to, as the documents say, obfuscate the origin of those emails? Until that happens, you know,
I don't think anything is going to be very clear, least of all to American citizens who are impoverished on regular news by watching TV news and reading places like the New York Times.
Great. Joe Laurie. Joe Laurie.
Yeah, Bill?
Joe Laurie.
Gotcha.
The Times and the Post both covered many stories from Snowden, and they even written about Vault 7.
Yeah.
That gives a cover, I think, to Assange. The only case they could possibly have is if they prove that he encouraged some way a whistleblower to obtain classified information. Mm-hmm. Is that right? Like,
yeah.
Publishing it is not a crime, and they're never going to be able to do that. What case do they really have against it?
Well, the case they're trying to build is conspiracy. That he... Yeah, well, you have to prove it. I mean, look, you know, they can always dig up evidence to prove it in quotes, okay? Joe, you ask exactly the right question. 6 years ago, they tried to make Julian Assange out to be a, guess what? What's the worst thing it can be? A terrorist. CNN had about 15 people on saying Julian Assange is not a journalist, he's a terrorist. The segment that I was on, luckily I didn't know this, but they let in with a clip from Bonnie and Clyde, okay? Shoot them all up, all right? Now, I spent 5 minutes explaining why, of course he's a journalist. And the interviewer says, now, Mr. McGovern, please, are you saying that he's a journalist? And I say, well, yeah, of course he's a journalist. They can't go down that road. They need to prove conspiracy. So. Is it beyond them to manufacture evidence that Julian Assange got in touch with Bradley Chelsea Manning or these other people? Of course it's not. Have they done it before? Of course they do it. They do it all the time. So Julian is very, very vulnerable. And unless we stand with him, unless we who care about the Constitution and the Bill of Rights and the First Amendment, I fear what will happen to him at the hands of these thugs, because that's what they are. Thanks, Joe.
Any other questions? Anne's friends from Code Pink have livened our background here. Any other questions? Thank you so much for coming.